very, very cheap, poorly made garment, or it doesn't look good to them anymore, that gets dumped too.
Yeah, so there's this the whole take back advertising that they've been doing just to entice people back into store, that there's somehow some circularity in it, that you take your clothes back and then they're deconstructed and goes back into a form of production, and the information that's coming out now, most of it just gets burnt for fuel.
That's right.
Yeah.
And the stuff that they are recycling is such a tiny percentage of what they're taking back.
Yeah.
But it's a very clever way for them to jump on the ethicality bandwagon and have a tiny section of their business looking good. So, sorry if that makes me sound cynical, but I've over the course of 12 years, and I know that the mass producing globalisation of fashion has been going on a little bit longer than that, but over the course of 12 years, I've just seen the industry, and in New Zealand, just shrink, because when you've got these maybe 10 huge fashion businesses controlling the world, you know, you're taking jobs away. There's really kids out, really clever kids out there that can design that will never get a chance to design because the small design houses are gone. You know, it's all one big factory, and well, not physically one big factory, but you know, that these big, big businesses are controlling it all, and they just exploiting everything and everyone and killing fashion the way we, you know, the way we've known it.
There was a thing, I saw it in my news feed, it was a couple of weeks ago, and it was a French brand, Vetements, and they, I don't know if you saw it, but they did this display in Stacks in New York in the department store, and they filled these really prominent department store windows, their front windows, full of waste clothing, just mounds of waste clothing. I thought, that's really interesting thing for a fashion brand to do. And then I thought, maybe what they're trying to achieve is an awareness between good quality fashion and that disposable fashion.
Yeah, I did see it. Yeah. I have to admit that I kind of went by it very quickly, but that's what I took away from it. It's like, good on you, you know, just keep that pressure on, and there's always going to be that market that will want and need fast fashion, but if we could just grow the discerning part of the market back, and so that they're educated and they know what they're buying and how long it's going to last, and yeah, I think that that's where the only chance for the fashion industry is, really. Yeah.
So anything that you're feeling optimistic about?
That my kids went to H&M, really excited to go and check it out, and they hated it. And I'm sorry, H&M, but you know, you just knew on the block here, and you know, you're right for the picking. But to me, it means that what I've said to them, what I've talked to them about, they're truly taking it on board now. And sure, they were sucked in by all the shiny, glittering things online and had to go and have a look, but they came out knowing that it, you know, it's not a good look. And yeah, you know, we're all about evolving your wardrobe here. Don't replace it every, you know, however
six
often.
Years.
Yeah. Get something that you can put back the stuff you've already got, you know, and just keep growing it that way. And you'll pull those old things back out because you'll have something new to put it with. So
yeah,
that's the way we see it, or I see it.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah.
Thank you. Lovely to talk to you.
Love what you're doing, Bernadette.
Oh, thank
Amazing.
You.
Amazing. Yeah.
Well, just trying to have this conversation around fashion and really just open it up, because it is such a major issue, and our clothing waste is our fastest growing waste stream.
Yes.
And it's just, it's frightening. So, yeah, the more we talk about it, we might get some clarity on it.
Yeah, and the other thing too is it's a massive industry. It's such a huge employer.
And it's worth $3 trillion or something like
that's
that.
That's right. So if you think about all the creative people that are tapped onto the fashion industry, photographers, models, graphic designers, the whole lot, you know, we don't want to lose that. We don't want to lose all that talent.
Yeah.
Because we are being dictated to by 10 great big stores.
Yeah.
And Amazon's still to come, so.
Oh my God, we need to have another conversation.
Yeah.
Thanks, Chris.
Thank you.
And thank you everyone for watching.